Hi, this is Jacob Wilson recording my first draft for Channel Fireball. We're going to do a Modern Masters, and I'm joined by Matt Ness.
Hi, everyone.
And I immediately got punished for drawing a Phantom Draft by opening Tarmogoyf. That just goes along. We just finished GP Houston, where Matt lost playing for top 8, and I got 17th on tiebreakers, so this just goes along with the theme of the day.
Blowouts after blowouts after blowouts. Fortunately, this one only daggers you because it's on your account, so it's really fine. So, what are we actually picking here?
I
On
was
a
leaning
brighter note.
towards Amuro Scout. I like Rebels a lot.
Yeah. We drafted Rebels in the last draft we did together, and it worked out pretty well.
Apparently, Modern Masters draft is just way too easy.
Is that Ricky?
Yep.
Yeah. Not surprised that he thinks that. It actually is pretty hard format, I think. There's like so many things you can do, and every card feels like, actually this pack's on the weaker side, but often you'll have multiple cards that you would just windmill slam first pick in, you know, their actual draft format. It's like other cards we could consider are like, I don't even know what else we could consider really. Like Mirror Enforcer is good if you're Affinity, but it's not a first pick really. Tarmogoyf's like pretty mediocre and limited. Like I honestly can't think of another card I would first pick out of that pack.
This pack is much better.
Yes, we did upgrade.
Apocrisite, Ephemeron, Finx, Aether Snipe, and Kithkin Greatheart are all pretty good.
Yeah. There's a couple cards that go really deep with Apocrisite, like the 3-mana 3/1 flyer who blinks something.
Yep, Flicker Wisp.
Flicker Wisp, yeah. You're familiar with that one? Has it beat you in the Grand Prix finals?
I don't recall.
So what are we taking here?
Do you think Apocrisite is the best card? Like
I don't know.
it's
I haven't
colorless,
played.
so it's we'll
Yeah,
play it no
I
matter
don't
what.
remember how it was. It was a rare in its original limited format, so I haven't played with it too much. I remember it being pretty good, but like Kitchen Finks is pretty gross, and Kitchen Greatheart's also pretty solid.
Okay, taking
Like
Finks.
the advantage of Apocrisite is it's also good in Affinity, so like if you want,
Well, the Affinity deck is blue-white, so you could probably play Finks.
yeah, I'm
I
just
don't
saying
know.
like Apocrisite's gonna be better if we end up Affinity. Otherworldly Journey goes deep with Apocrisite, right? So now we're spewing. That's
Goes
tough.
deep with Finks, too.
Kind, yeah. And then it gets a +1/+1 counter, so it, yeah, it doesn't really matter. So
Yeah, it
like if
doesn't
it's
work.
persisted, then you unpersist it, and it's bigger, and you gain life, and then it will can persist again. It's like a lot of value. We could just take it, but that seems so aggressive.
I think it'll definitely wheel.
Yeah, we can probably get Otherworldly Journey later. So what do we want out of this pack?
The best
Blinding
card
Beam's
is
actually
like,
impressed me a lot.
yeah, I think Blinding Beam is very good, but it's also gonna wheel.
You do? But well that but the, like we can't get both of them on the wheel.
Yeah, but
We're gonna have
since
to
there's
pick.
three packs, like, we'll get one of each if you
Okay,
want.
okay. So like the best card is Rift Bolt, is that right?
Yeah, but
You don't
like,
really want to
do you
be
want to
Rebel
stick to
Splash Red.
like black white?
I don't think Rebels has to be black white. Like,
There are a lot of good red cards.
yeah, I'm not
We
opposed
could
to
also
being
just
like,
take Drag Down.
I think Rift Bolt is enough better than Drag Down that even though black pairs better, maybe it's not a big deal. But I could be wrong. So, what do
Yeah,
you
there's
think here?
like Take Possession and Pester might make it seem like blue might be open.
Yeah.
So we could. If we'd taken the drag down, it would have been easier to transition into fairies.
I mean,
But.
Blue White's actually a pretty sweet deck. Blue White, the idea is you're supposed to have some synergy with each color combination has something going for it, right? Like,
Yeah.
Blue White's like the comes into play ability blink type of thing. I don't know why actual momentary blink isn't in this
Yeah,
set.
it would make a lot of sense.
I can't
But.
figure it out, but.
Take Possession's very good, but costs
Yeah.
seven.
Like, we saw like a Court Homunculus earlier, and there's one here. If those both wheel, we could get the Artifact Aggro deck. And there's like a Shrapnel Blast also in this pack, but I don't know if that's
Yeah,
going too deep.
I like Affinity, but yeah, it
But you
always
want
feels
it.
like a jump to take one of the cards since they're not very
Yeah.
good.
Maybe the right strategy with Affinity is to take monocolored cards early, and then if you see the Affinity cards late, that's when you move. I'm not really sure.
So here's there's Avian Changeling and Apocrisite again. The Changeling is a rebel and it pumps Kithkin Greatheart. It's just an okay card.
think I would take Apocrysite on the grounds that we could wheel that Otherworldly Journey, and it also, if we end up like just blue-red or something and just abandon ship, or like any other combination that isn't white, then like there's upside there.
Okay, that's
and,
fine.
And even if we end up like white-blue or whatever, we might just not have a strong Kithkin theme.
Jeez.
And rewarded with your favorite card, Flicker Wisp.
Yeah, there's also Electrolyze and Blightspeaker.
Yeah, I don't think Blightspeaker is really in the discussion. Electrolyze is just because the card is so disgusting.
Yep, look but at all these X-Files right here.
Yeah, but I think I would still flick.
Okay.
I mean, it is close.
Flicker Wisp is very good.
Yeah. We already have like two things that go insane with it and one other thing with mild synergy. Yeah.
At a bare minimum, it removes a blocker or gives something vigilance.
Yeah.
And another one.
Wow.
I think we'll definitely get a blind EV if we want one.
2, 4, 6, 8. It would literally be last pick if it was this one.
Yeah, but the other one or...
Yeah, I gotcha.
Here's another Cold Eye Selkie. 2 in a row.
They made Cold Eye Selkie still a rare. That's so weird. They powered down all the other underpowered rares, but they left that one. I do not understand a lot of the decisions they made with this set, I gotta be honest.
They probably didn't spend that much time since...
Yeah.
They want to spend time on...
I mean, they had to build M14 at the same exact time.
Yeah.
Our deck is gonna go very deep.
Hopefully. I am a fan of going deep. You like Otherworldly Journey here.
Yeah. Joyra's Uncommon, is that right?
Is Spell Snare just a okay card? I've never played with it in
London. I don't think so, but I'm not sure. In RGD, it was pretty bad because everyone's deck was really dirtily, so it's hard to say. This format's almost like Cube, where Spell Snare is good-ish.
Well, there's nothing else to take, so...
Yeah, like, is there any chance we, like, backdoor green off the Kitchen Finks and want, like...
This Courage?
Gather Courage or Thalid? I don't know. Probably not.
I think Spell Snare.
Or if we just...
And apparently Shahar is in the finals.
Of course. Not at all surprising.
It's just nothing surprising about these events.
Is this definitely the pick?
No, I just right-clicked.
Okay. Like, you can play a fair deck with Empty, and actually Brute Force is pretty good, too. This is actually a really interesting pick.
Yeah, but... So you want to just try to be blue-red... white-red?
That's, like, definitely a possibility. We already have Rift Bolt to go with Empty.
Well, I'll just take Brute Force.
Okay.
Jeez.
Oh, wow. I think I would... Like, Sends Enlistment is pretty mediocre, so I think I would take Otherworldly Journey in case we do go very, very deep, but...
Like, what other really good cards are there? Like, Mole Drifter?
Aether Snipe. There's a lot. Like, especially if we stay blue-white, like...
Okay.
Riftwing Cloudskate,
Yeah, a lot of those are uncommon.
Sure, but that doesn't mean you don't pick them up.
Alright, nothing here. Is this card good, Death the Nine? Seems like it could be.
It's, like, pretty clunky. It's good with Hanakami, you can just go infinite.
Jeez, this is a very, like, Blightspeaker and Cold Eye Selkie.
Which one are you going to take?
Blightspeaker.
Okay. So you don't really think we're going to play the Cold Eye Selkie?
It's unlikely.
Yeah, I'm pretty much agree with
We're
you.
Definitely white, but we could be anything else.
Yeah, literally anything else. We don't really have any Rebels yet, which is a bit of a problem, I guess. Ooh, this pack suggests that we
There are a lot of drag downs going around, so we probably could have... We'll probably get some this pack, too.
Drag down isn't actually good if you have a two-color deck, though. Yeah. It's kind of a weird card.
Yeah, there's a lot of removal in this set, so it's not as premium as it is in other sets.
Yeah. This format is definitely not like any other. So what do you want to take here?
There's a lot of really
There's
good
like
cards.
Zero playable blue cards, which is kind of awkward, and zero playable white cards.
Well, yeah. We're definitely... Whatever card we take, we're going to wheel a black card.
Yeah. Well, we could... So, we're taking... I assume we're taking a black or red card out of this pack, right?
Yeah.
Like, the options are, like...
Is Garganite good?
It's definitely good. We don't really have a whole... We have a Finks, as far as, like, pseudo-synergy, and Apocrysite has some synergy with it.
Yeah.
But, like, Tombstalker's pretty gross, and Marsh Flitter's pretty gross, and goes with our Blink theme, like...
Ooh. Yeah, I think that's enough reason to take Mark Fuller. Yeah, I already wanted it.
We can wheel the sculler. That would be, like, really sweet.
We don't really have, like, cheap things to go in a graveyard to work with Tombstalker.
Yeah. Tombstalker might actually cost like 6 mana or whatever most games.
And Marsh Flitter sounds excellent with blinking.
Yeah, I'm pretty excited. So we didn't wheel the Blinding Beam from the last pack.
Yeah, but this one's earlier, so I think we have a better chance.
Yeah, well, how many... it's on the border.
We probably won't, but Hirobi's Whisper is better anyway.
Yeah, the only argument against Hirobi's Whisper is the double black. But if we end up two colors, our mana should be decent enough.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, we have 4 blank effects right now, so all the Marsh Flitter and Enter the Battlefield effects seem very good.
Yeah. Does Kiki Jiki Flicker Wisp go infinite? Oh, no, it's end of turn, right?
Yeah, end of turn.
Oh, man.
We could have gone very deep.
That would have been exciting. Oh, we have Pestermite, though. We could still do it.
Ooh. The white, black, red, green.
No, we like, if we did that, what we'd have to do is move out of black, move into red, and then, like, splash the blue.
Yeah.
It's a lot of effort, but I know this is one of your favorite combos.
One of my favorite combos is 3 colors, splash, Kiki Jiki.
in cube. Yeah. It's a little more viable in cube than it is here.
I think I'm just going to take Bone Splitter.
This is so depressing. I really want to kill someone with infinite.
Yeah, so do
Infinity Fairies.
Can't really blame you for that.
Yeah. Oh, wow. I think Black-White is actually the right place for us.
Yeah, you don't say. We're probably going to wheel this Blightspeaker, too.
Oh, that's cool. Meadow Boon triggers on Leaves Play, so it actually works with Flicker Wisp also.
Yeah, so it's between this Meadow Boon and this Trapper.
I think Trapper might be enough better that it doesn't matter that Meadow Boon goes deep in our deck, but I could be wrong.
Meadow Boon is a very good card.
Yeah, I didn't play a whole lot of that format. You probably weren't even playing then, right?
Yeah, I have no idea. I'm just guessing. It looks good.
It's you know that it's Leaves Play, not Enders Play, right?
Yes, I know it's Leaves Play. That's why it has Evoke. Actually, Evoke would work
better. Yeah, it's weird. Half the Evoke cards say Enter Play and half say Leave Play, and it's very confusing to keep track of. Our curve's pretty good. I think I would. Yeah. I don't know. I would Trapper, but.
Pilfers is another Enders Battlefield card we can try to get.
Yeah, we could wheel that one maybe. Oh, so the Scholar didn't. Oh, no, the Scholar's this pack, yeah.
No, we haven't even started wheeling yet.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. This is 5th pack. I like wasn't thinking about it.
Yeah, so we'll probably.
This card could go in our comes into playability deck, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, there are a lot of cards, actually.
This card's like a Ravenous Rats for us with
flying. Well, we have one more fairy.
Okay, okay. Well, we could have Infinity Fairies.
I think that ship has sailed.
you don't want to go Infinity Fairies Thieving Sprite combo?
I definitely want to.
But you want to win the draft even more?
Yes.
Is Tidal Scholar even good with Blink Effects?
You have to wait until you have 4 mana.
And then Otherworldly Journey it? Yeah, that's kind of sweet, I guess. What are we taking out of this pack?
We could take a 3rd Journey or Test of Faith.
Test of Faith is certainly a better card. Yeah, neither do I. Test of Faith is like a much better card than Otherworldly Journey.
Yes.
Just in the dark. But obviously, you know, you don't
try. We're trying to go deep.
I'm in favor of going deep. Like, now Apocrysite will be actually bonkers.
Yeah, and then
although now I'm regretting not having the second one.
Well, yeah, I think let's take Journey and just see how good we can make it.
Yeah, like, we're doing this to, like, learn, right? Like,
let's just take Bob.
Man, Bob and Tarmogoyf?
Yeah, Bob, Goyf, Kiki Jiki, we could have been rich.
Obviously, we wouldn't have gotten this Bob this late if this was a real one.
We certainly would have gotten the Goyf.
Yeah.
And I think, our curve is really low. I think Bob might make the cut.
Yeah. Like, if Bob works in your deck, it's usually very, very good, is my limited experience.
Hmm. Well, this doesn't really go well with the Bob, and this goes well with the Blinks.
That card's so much worse than the other one, though. It's a tough pick.
A 3-mana 1/1 flyer, or a destroy target non-green creature.
Yeah. I'm not opposed to taking the flyer. We're trying to go as deep as possible, right?
This is pretty expensive.
Yeah, like, as you said,
our deck... Removal isn't as premium as it
normally is. And as you said, our deck isn't, like, very good at delving. Mm-hmm. All right, let's go deep.
Deep it is. Ooh.
Wow.
We have our choice.
I think we're going to pick up enough Rebel Searchers and therefore should Scholar.
Okay, we have 2 Rebel Searchers. Do we have any Rebels?
We have a Wrathy Trapper.
Okay.
So I would Scholar, but both.
Is the Edict not good?
It's mediocre at best. Like, a lot of decks have changelings.
So that's a reason that it's better, right?
Well, no.
Oh, that player.
Okay. Yeah, they get goblins.
I thought it was the opposite.
Oh, no, it is not the opposite. And also, some decks have tokens and stuff like that. Like, just a lot of ways that you can get blown out with that card.
Okay, so we could take this 1-1, or Test of Faith, or Gleam.
It has to be Test of Faith, right? Is there a reason you want a 1-mana 1-1?
No, I thought this card was different. I thought it, like, sacked to give something -1/-1.
No, it's not, like, Mob Fanatic.
Okay. Yeah, well, I'll just take Test of Faith.
How many Gobbos do we have? We have Marsh Flitter Gobbos.
Marsh Flitter. That's it.
That's it? That's depressing.
Well, there's nothing else, so we'll just take it.
Yeah, sure. What does it do, by the way?
It's a 2/2. Other Goblins get +1.
Oh, and it can regenerate another Goblin.
So it's pretty good.
You can really protect that Marsh Flitter Goblin.
Our deck looks pretty good.
Yeah.
The curve is pretty insane.
Yeah, yeah. I think Bob will be making an appearance. Good old Bobbert.
Yeah, this format's pretty weird. It's a lot like Cube.
Yeah. You can just keep attacking with Bob if push comes to shove. Like, we're going to be the beatdown anyway, so.
And we have a little life gain.
Yeah. Well, and by a little life game, you mean if we draw Kitchen Finks, we can't possibly lose?
Yes.